Okay, so indecision. Thank you. So indecision. If there's indecision, some of the things I do with indecision, it also depends on the context of the situation, but if one of the things I like to do with indecision is try and initially feel all the feelings out around it. And if you feel out all the feelings, often that will aid in your spiritual consciousness going up and you being able to tune into a higher vibration, a higher level of consciousness, and often the intuitions come in. One of the things is, as you feel out all the feelings, even, you see, there's two aspects. There's like your level of consciousness, and then there's your ego. And often, when you get to higher levels of consciousness, you'll do things, and your ego will not even know why you're doing them, or why that option is chosen, but they'll tend to be right. So it's like, when you're at a low level of consciousness, you have a lot of suppressed feelings and a lot of mental chatter, you can still be in indecision, but often the choices you make will often be wrong. Because you're at a low level of consciousness and you're cut off from the light of consciousness. So even though you don't know what you're doing and you're making choices, generally most of your choices will end up going bad. But if you start feeling your feelings out and start letting go of your attachment to thoughts, your vibration starts to increase. And sometimes even, this is quite useful to know, sometimes even as you're conscious, like you're not sure, for example, if there was a decision, should I stay in this country or should I leave for another country? As you just feel out those energies and those vibrations, your ego may still not be sure, but in the end you may make a choice, and that will often be the right choice if you felt out all your feelings. Sometimes when you feel out all your feelings, you'll get a clear intuition. That's ideal. But even if you feel out all your feelings and you make a decision, and your ego's saying, I'm still not sure, it'll probably still be the right decision. Because you're in an attractive field, which generally takes care of you to make the right choices and decisions. It's also good to do, if there are things which are holding you, that are, you know, that, like you've got a grievance or resentments or fears, you can do the Course in Miracles on that, pray for a miracle and shift in perception, or pray to see peace instead of that, or you can do cancelling of beliefs around certain things like, oh, there's no jobs in London, I need to move to Germany where there's more jobs, or whatever it is. You can cancel your belief that there's not enough job opportunities in London. So that, you know, if that's what, so there could be belief systems at play and why you think there's no, there's no potential good mates in London. There's probably a lot more mates in the US, so I should go to the US to find a partner. Then if you can't, you believe there are, something might show up here in London. So it could be a limiting belief, and the energies as well. Sometimes, for me, another important aspect what people in 12-step knows as geographicals. And geographicals are like when they're going, it's not always the case, but sometimes, like, if you have enough bad experiences in one place, you think that if you go to another country it's all going to be good, you know. So it's like everything's gone wrong in this country, and I know that the grass is greener in Japan, you know. And once I go to Japan, I won't be in this country, and it's going to be amazing. And there, sometimes it can, that, so that's more of an ego thing if it's from that level of consciousness. Because another thing to realize is that, you know, another angle to see things that you can. Wherever you are, you can transcend the world. And actually, even though it's true that, you know, spirit may call you to a different country or to a different place, and that might intuitively naturally unfold, but in terms of happiness, peace and joy, it isn't in a specific location. Like, you can transcend the whole world in like in Brixton or in central London. But, you know, that doesn't mean that sometimes if you get connected to your intuition when you do spiritual work, that you may end up in a different country, because it's like the universe wants you in a different country. But if it's an ego motive, then it could be because of beliefs or associations, or thinking that the grass is greener if I just leave this place and go somewhere else. But it's good to clear up. It's good to clear up any sort of negative associations, any limiting beliefs. So limiting beliefs, like I cancel my belief. If it was job opportunities, cancel my belief. There's no job opportunities in London. I'm an infinite being subject only to what I hold in mind. Or if you've had negative associations, you could, you know, pray for a miracle to see peace instead of fear. And then see, after you've cleared it, and if you've got like a negative charge, then if you sit with your feelings until you get to a sense of peace, and you still feel you want to move countries, then it's probably going to be from a higher guidance. Or you might just get very direct, clear intuition. But everything is orchestrated by level of consciousness. So if you're in a lot of fear, or if you're in a lot of bad associations or negative beliefs, that might be the reason why you're moving, as opposed to it being a clear thing from spirit. So often if you can clear everything, and usually anyway, it's good to, if you leave for another country and you haven't cleared everything, all the negative associations and the negative feelings in this country, it's a missed opportunity for me. And usually, like, you'll probably have to transcend it in the other country, you know, when you get there. So that's what I say. One of the prayers I like, which Dr. Hawkins, just pray, you can pray to God for enlightenment as to whether I should be moving countries, pray for God to reveal the truth, whether I should be in this country or not, sit with feelings, do the Course in Miracles, see if you can process as much of it out. Also, what I say is, like, it's never a good idea to make a decision unless it's urgent. Don't make any decisions while you're in negativity. Mm. So if you're in like guilt, shame, fear or anger, and you have that charge within you, or an obsession, like, you know, I don't know what, like George Clooney's now in Japan, I have to go now. Like, let me put the ticket now. That's like obsession or a strong feeling. It's not good to make the choice on that. Because those are very strong ego emotions, or obsessions are very strong ego thinking systems going on. So you're not connected to source or spirit. So if you can like let those go through prayer and sitting with feelings or doing the observer, then you'll be tuned into a higher level of consciousness. And then that will just automatically orchestrate. You know, as you get to those higher levels of consciousness, it's usually in the interest of the highest good. There's a higher wisdom which you connect to, which is unknown by the ego, which will guide you into where you should be and what you should be doing. But for me, when I'm making decisions, I'll always like wait until the last minute if I have to make a decision, and I'll be praying, I'll be sitting with my feelings, I'll be going to the observer. I'll know that if I can raise my consciousness around that thing to the last minute, the choice I'll make, I know, will be a higher choice. So I never try and make fast decisions. I'm also an addict. My background is addiction. So here's another thing which I say to people, is never do things compulsively or on an urge. Because I come from an addiction background. Because when you're in the ego, things are very compulsive and you have this strong urge to do it now. Mm. You know, very, very strong urge to do it now. Like I had, like we have the money fellowships where you have shopping addiction. You know, like if you have a very, very strong feeling, you buy something immediately. You know, you're going to go and buy something. And I had this thing, I remember once when I was in the early days of my spiritual recovery and I had the news that I was going to have an operation. And I'd been like idolizing this projector, you know, it was kind of a boy toy, projector. And I thought, I got the news, you've got to go for an operation. I had this strong fear. And I thought, and I was thinking about this projector, and so I rang up the shop, and I didn't want to buy it. I just wanted to ask them just to talk a little bit about them with the phone, the shopkeeper. So I rang the guy up and said, "Do you have it in stock?" And he said, "Are you interested? I just want to know what the best price you can do." And he said to me, "If you buy now, I'll give you a free projector screen, but you have to buy it right now." And so I was in this fear, and I just rang up just for a phone call, and he said, "Buy it now, you have to buy it right now, and I'll give you a free screen with it." So I said, "Yes." So I spent £1,800 and I got this projector. And it's like everything you do on addiction, it's like great for about 3 weeks. You know, like a big screen put Star Wars on my whole wall, and you had the fighters going, and it was like amazing, immersive, having a cinema screen in your own room. And then after 3 weeks, I didn't want to use it. So that's the thing, you know, that's like the compulsiveness, or you what, and sometimes like the ego will fantasize about something for a long time, and if you go into stress, you'll do that thing. Like I was fantasizing about that projector, but because I was serene, I knew that wasn't really a thing to do. It's just like a curiosity of my ego. But when I went into the fear, then suddenly I ended up with a projector. So that's what I mean. Like, so, I know a lot of people will think, like, if only I could live on the Bahamas on a beach every day, then my life would be sorted out. And then they get really, really stressed out. And then they book their flight to the Bahamas. And they think that's the cure. I'm not saying that, but people in addiction do that type of thing. They'll go off to another country and think it's it's something like that. So, yeah, that's what I'd say on indecision. Is there anything else to say on indecision? I mean, I usually take the process. I mean, I just take the process of just trying to transcend the world. Or just transcend my feelings, or just transcend my thoughts to go to the highest level of consciousness. To what, you know, I always think that when the problem no longer bothers me, whether it's a location I'm at or a person, and I've transcended it, I'm at peace, and it doesn't bother me at all, that's the best time to make the choice, if there's a choice to make. I've often found as an addict, like if I want to do something and I feel out all the feelings until I'm in a place of neutrality, then it's not important any longer. You know, like I did this with food addiction, it might be relevant, like donuts, you know, if there's donuts, if I sit with the craving, just keep sitting with the craving until there's no craving left, then whether there's a donut there or a biscuit there, it doesn't matter. It's nothing. It's a neutral object. But before that time, I'm thinking that's the solution. You know, and the same would be with love addiction. The same would be with geographics or different countries. Often, if you feel out all the feelings, the thing that you think you need to do, you don't need to do it. You know, and you end up like. that's the great thing. One of the things is, as you go to higher levels of consciousness, there usually isn't anything you need to. There's nothing. All enlightened teachers say there's nothing they need or want. You can't give them a cheesecake, and they're going to be even more happy because they had a cheesecake. You can't say, here's a free flight to the Bahamas because you're going to be happier in the Bahamas, because they're not going to be happier in the Bahamas because they're just as happy here as they would be in the Bahamas. Or if you say, I'm going to give you a winning lottery ticket, it still would be quite meaningless to them because they're not going to be even happier after winning the lottery. So that's also something that, so you become more an instrument, you become more orchestrated by the universe. The ego, at the levels of enlightenment, there is what happens is the chooser who thinks they're in separation disappears. So everything unfolds out of the present moment. So even that, but that's at advanced levels. But while you still have an ego, there's still something that's attached to thoughts thinking it needs to make choices. So that starts to go away at higher levels. Okay, I'll stop there.